Hello and welcome to today's Daily Market Update with me, Josh Mahony, Research Analyst here at Alpari UK. So today we're going to take a look at what's moving the markets, and again it's the fiscal cliff is pretty much the only thing on the agenda at the moment. So over the weekend it was one of the biggest weekends in recent American economic history because this deal really needed to be completed. You know, we've had the whole presidential election where he said that he was going to actually see Christmas as the deadline for a resolution on this whole issue, but now it's come down to the last day and we still haven't got anything whatsoever. So meetings took place on Friday evening, Great British time, and then also through to Sunday as well, and basically nothing has actually happened by the sounds of it. A lot of the noises coming out of both the Republican and Democrat side are just basically talking about some substantial differences in terms of opinions, and some of the major sticking points seem to be basically within the Republican side as to whether they're actually going to allow any of the tax hikes on the rich people to be put through, which they're not willing to do so. And we've heard that for an extended period of time now. You know, previously the Republicans were talking about, you know, closing out loopholes to try and generate some sort of cash, but we've had Obama wanting to increase the budget over there, and therefore he needs more money in his mind. There was a previous figure of $1.6 trillion that banded around that he wanted to increase the government budget by. You know, closing loopholes by the sounds of it isn't going to be doing that kind of thing. So we've kind of come to an impasse now, and it looks like nothing's happened over the weekend. And Harry Reid, the House representative or the Senate representative for the Democrats, has actually come out saying that they're going to have another meeting today, but he doesn't expect any sort of resolution anytime soon. Mitch McConnell, on the other hand, is saying that maybe they should bring Joe Biden in, like he's going to somehow resolve it with a magical touch or something. I mean, it doesn't look like any sort of deal is going to be happening. It looks like we're going to get pushed over the fiscal cliff. There's a lot of posturing on either side, as has been going on for some weeks now, and Obama's sort of laying the blame, and then John Boehner's saying, oh, you know, you've been brought in to lead the economy or lead the country, not to actually start pointing fingers. But at the end of the day, that's what's going to happen, because the voters want someone to blame, and, you know, Republicans want the Democrats to be at the end of it, and then the Democrats want the Republicans to be blamed. But at the end of the day, it doesn't make a difference. We are where we are, and it looks like going forward we're probably going to go over the fiscal cliff. Now all the markets are down as a result of this, and we don't know what's actually going to happen tomorrow. You know, has it been factored in because people are now expecting this to be happening, or are we going to see, you know, some serious drop-offs in the markets in response to this fiscal cliff? Now President Barack Obama is actually looking forward now to not actually resolving it before the fiscal cliff, but actually mentioning what he would do if they did actually go over the fiscal cliff. He cited a meeting on the 4th of January where Congress get back together, and he's saying that he's essentially going to just draw up some new legislation that's going to kind of get those $250,000 earners or less, actually kind of bring those tax breaks forward for them, and therefore that's that 98% of the population that he's been talking about covered, which he's been mentioning for a long period of time now, saying that's the core to what he actually wants to be done. You know, he would like higher taxes on the likes of the high earners, but it's those middle income people that he wants to protect the most, so he says. So looking across to the Eurozone, there's a couple of little things that have happened, but again, it's the fiscal cliff that's the major story of the day, and all the markets are moving in response to that. However, Angela Merkel has used her New Year's speech to actually say that, you know, a lot of the emphasis has been taken away from the Eurozone at the moment. Everyone's talking about the fiscal cliff, but it doesn't necessarily mean that the Eurozone crisis has been fixed. You know, there's a lot of vigilance that needs to be done on the behalf of a lot of the Eurozone leaders and people within the Eurozone to make sure that some of these austerity measures are followed through to their full effect. She's also kind of turned to the people within her own population who are obviously critical of the Eurozone. It's taken up a lot of their tax euros, and she's saying there's a lot of benefits that are to be had from being within a strong European Union, and that we should basically stick it out and try and see through these austerity measures. Also looking across to France, they threw out a potential 75% tax on millionaires, which, you know, it doesn't really mean that much in terms of what's going to be happening within the markets. However, you know, it is just one of the austerity measures that's trying to be pushed through, but essentially they've said that it's not going to be done anytime soon. That's just one of the notable things that's happened within the Eurozone. So taking a look at the charts, if you look at the cable chart, it's sort of trading marginally lower at the moment, around about 1.617. Now, obviously, the overriding sentiment at the moment is completely dictated by the fiscal cliff, and people use the US dollar as sort of safe haven currency. Therefore, you would expect to see the US dollar higher against some of these pairs, which means that you would see the likes of cable and the euro dollar lower. And that has been seen today in the charts. It's only marginally so, and in actual fact, it's reversed a lot of the losses that we had in early trading this morning. However, we're expecting to see the market sort of waiting out pretty low volume at the moment, given the fact that there's a holiday and everything. There's pretty low volume, so everyone's basically waiting out to see what's going on in the fiscal cliff. So we would expect it to remain around the same kind of area. I mean, the trading range that it's in at the moment is around about where that 23.6 and the zero Fibonacci levels are, and that is around about 1.63. down to around about 1.606. So I think the trading range will be within there for the foreseeable future until we actually get some sort of decent sense of direction as predicted by the fiscal cliff. I mean, if you were to completely look at it from a sort of technical point of view, you might look at the stochastic, which is in an upwards momentum, and therefore that would be a bullish move. So that would push back towards that 1.63 mark. However, obviously we will need some sort of significant news to come out of the US for this to be moving one way or the other, and it should be completely dictated by the fiscal cliff for the time being. And also, if you look at the euro dollar chart, it's the same kind of story. It's trading within a pretty tight boundary at the moment, a sort of sideways channel. It again is down today around about that 1.319 mark, and it's touched on that lower boundary that basically it's formed a sort of double top formation with over the last sort of 2 weeks of trading. Usually that would be seen as a bearish momentum, but then again, we were essentially look into the fiscal cliff to get some sort of sense of direction, so I wouldn't read into that too much. The RSI has just moved out of sort of overbought territory, so that would mean a move to the downside, which again couples up with that double top formation. But yeah, we're going to look at that fiscal cliff and see what the resolution is in that, and then be looking back towards the technicals in future. So that's it for today, guys, and if you want to check out any more news and analysis, come and look at the Alpari newsroom. That's at alpari.co.uk/newsroom, or check me out on Twitter. My name's Josh Mahoney, research analyst here at Alpari UK. Have a great day.